It is. Time to freak out! Is Google's fancy new ethics board the only thing that stands between us and total annihilation at the hands of artificial intelligence? Hi, my name is Emily, and this is Blink Pop Shift. First, let's start with the news. Google, for the measly sum of around $500 million, is acquiring the UK-based artificial intelligence startup DeepMind. But what makes this acquisition more interesting than Google's slew of other buys? Well, along with a deal to secure some still super secret AI tech, Google agreed to found an ethics board to oversee its future forays. DeepMind was founded by video game prodigy and neuroscientist Demis Hassabis, along with AI alarmist Shane Legg and Mustafa Suleiman. So why an ethics board? Well, it might have something to do with Shane Legg's statement that he believes that in the next century, artificial intelligence may play a crucial role in an extinction level event for humans. Scary stuff, right? But then, wild speculation usually is. While we often jump to malfeasance on the part of the AI when our fears about death by robot are triggered, but these systems are just as likely to cause harm by accident. Take the incident in 2009 when the South African military deployed a partially autonomous robo-cannon which ended up killing 9 soldiers and injuring 14 more. Though reports disagree as to whether this was a software or hardware malfunction, it does get the mind skittering down some pretty dark alleyways. So, now that everyone is sufficiently nervous, let's talk ethics. Because this is so new, there's very little information about the proposed powers or responsibilities of the board. And I'm not here to speculate, but I do want to talk about what ethics are in relationship to machines. And while I am a huge fan of science fiction, let's not jump all the way to the still far off ethical quandaries posed by truly aware artificial moral agents. Oh, an artificial moral agent is what AMA actually stands for. Like, whether or not it's ethical to turn off a self-aware AI, or if Asimov's laws are really enough, or how to govern the treatment of AI by humans, usually called roboethics. But instead, let's look at some near-term ethical quandaries that this board is likely to weigh in on. One other note, I'm not going to be covering the military applications of AI in this video. I promise to cover it in the future, but as the board is internal to Google, I'm going to keep this strictly private sector. There are lots of different kinds of AI algorithms out there, and one of the most basic ethical questions we can ask about them is who gets to stick around? Should we promote diversity or uniformity? Here are 3 examples of current species of AI. Decision trees are a transparent and predictable form of AI, but are also less flexible than other models. They give humans the most control and understanding over every step in the computer's thinking. Unfortunately, the predictability and ease of use of decision trees also makes this form of AI the most susceptible to hackers. Neural networks are a type of AI that are just now beginning to mimic the functionality of the human prefrontal cortex. They create networks of interconnected nodes that are capable of flexible and robust machine learning. Unfortunately, much like the human mind, you don't always know what's going on under the hood. Genetic algorithms are self-coding AI that tune and improve over time based on natural selection-like processes. Once this AI is set a problem, the code evolves the best possible computational solution with little further human input. But should any one of these solutions win out over all the others? Should we artificially limit the diversity of AI species to make them easier to control? And if you do vote for a one AI fits all system, the algorithm you choose will be based on what you value. Control and understanding? Flexible learning? Or brute force natural selection? It worked for us, why not artificial intelligence too? Okay, now that you have your systems all picked out, now you have to decide what they're allowed to do. Can they run the economy? Banks? Trading firms and financial institutions galore have designed and implemented very smart and very fast trading systems that buy and sell hundreds of trades a minute. Is it ethical for these companies to design their AI employees to squeeze as much money out of the market as possible, or should there be a focus on improving the wealth of the entire population? Do these AI have a responsibility to the greater good, or the company that owns them? Once you've decided who and how your software functions, you have to consider the added complexity that comes when AI are paired with hardware bodies, like, say, self-driving cars. There are minor questions, like should a mesh network of cars, which can all communicate to one another, shape traffic to allow one of their kind to speed ahead because it's carrying a passenger late for a flight? But what about late for a meeting? Can empty cars pick up app-enabled hitchhikers too poor to afford a car themselves? Once autonomous cars are carefully controlling the road, should humans be allowed to drive at all? And if an accident does occur, do the cars choose to swerve based on the passenger contents of each vehicle? Old man here, school bus there. There's a lot to think about here, including whether or not an ethics board is the best tool for the job. The campaign finance industry, for example, has a plethora of ethics boards tasked with overseeing elections. And we all know how sane and equitable that always is. If you want to read more, I highly recommend Moral Machines, Teaching Robots Right from Wrong by Wendell Wallet and Colin Allen. They make the point that time may prove us poor prophets of disaster. Our intent in predicting catastrophe is not to be sensational or instill fear. The purpose of prediction is to draw attention to the need for work on moral machines now. Predicting horrors, in other words, may ultimately help us prevent them. But what do you think? Will envisioning disaster now help us prevent it in the future? And if you were on Google's new ethics board, what rules would you want to implement? Next, we will talk specifically about how Google is using AI to launch next-gen search, but until then, please leave a comment below on Tumblr or at Emily Eifler. And as always, thank you for watching and get curious.
Is the show really over?
Well, along with the extinction level event for humans. Humans! And I can be a human. Humans! For humans! Humans! It might have something to do with